It is indeed a blessing to be able to nurture it and be a part of the fascinating journey of PILF. We start with an amazing performance of sand art presented by Prasad Sonavne. Welcome to the Pune International Literary Festival. Literature is like the pigeon of peace. It spreads peace and love. Literature and art heal and nurture and feed the craving heart. PILF serves just that, growing and building strong connections between the reader and author. between the creative person and the aspiring one. PILF is a hub of throbbing creative energy that evokes a desire to create in the restless minds, while simultaneously satiates the curious and hungry minds. The social theme this year is family as the core of society. Because families love, support, encourage, and help achieve dreams. PILF is a festival with a heart. It creates bonds and sparks inspiration. Thank you. And this year too, PILF will take you on a literary adventure. That's a promise. That was brilliant. Thank you, Prasad. It is time to go down the memory lane with a short 2-minute film, PILF Glimpses. After witnessing the adventurous literary journey of PILF, we have a surprise clipping from Dr. Shashi Tharoor. Dr. Tharoor had planned to participate in the festival this year with multiple sessions, including the launch of Voice of the Runes by Dr. Manjari Prabhu. Due to unavoidable circumstances, he had to cancel his program, but he has sent his best wishes to PILF and Manjari. Let us see what he has to say.
I'm sorry not to be with you all, as had been planned and promised, amongst other things, to launch Manjari Prabhu's book, Voice of the Runes. She has always impressed me as somebody with tremendous drive, one of the organizers of the Pune Literary Festival, and also an intrepid storyteller with a particular taste for exotic European locations. We're all used to European thriller writers and American thriller writers setting mysteries in India. But now we have an Indian writer who goes to Europe and finds old castles, mysterious old languages, and dramatic developments to write about set in Europe. Exoticizing the Occident is something we can give Manjari Prabhu credit for. She'll put you on the edge of your seat with her thriller, Voice of the Runes. I wish her all the very best, even though I can't watch it in person. I am with you in spirit, wishing her all success, and wishing all of you at the Pune Literary Festival a stimulating time. Thank you.
That was amazing. It calls for a big round of applause for Dr. Manjari Prabhu. I now request the festival director, Dr. Manjari Prabhu, to escort our esteemed guests onto the stage. Dr. Manjari Prabhu, director of the festival. Our special guest, His Excellency, Mr. Lorenzo Angeloni, Italian ambassador to India and Nepal. Ms. Shobha De, senior acclaimed author and esteemed member of our advisory board. Mr. Bharat Agarwal, managing director, Vishwakarma Publications. Mr. Rahul Karad, executive president, MIT World Peace University. The festival director, Dr. Manjari Prabhu, will now welcome our guests. Thank you, Dr. Manjari. Let us now light the lamp to mark the opening of the festival. May I request all the guests to light the lamp, please? Thank you. We would like to express our gratitude to our partners and sponsors and acknowledge their help and support in this endeavor. We would request His Excellency, Mr. Lorenzo Angeloni, to felicitate our esteemed partners. Mr. Bharat Agarwal, Vishwakarma Publications, our title partner. Mr. Rahul Karad, MIT World Peace University, our associate partner. Mr. Benjamin Glahn, Salzburg Global Seminar, our international partner. He's not here, but we do acknowledge him. Mr. Prashant Joshi, from Leap and Scale, our partner for the special stream for children, Treasure Island. Nakisa Silva of Fabilizer, our bronze partner. Mr. Akash Shah, Jayco Publishing House, our bronze partner. Mr. Rajaram Raul, Fingerprint, our exhibition partner. Mr. Prathamesh Patil, Sula Vineyards, our beverage partner. Mr. Akash Gupta, Crossword, our bookstore partner. Mrs. Shania Mehta, Jet Airways, our airline partner. We also acknowledge Mahindra, our bronze partner. Swiss Arts Council, Prohelvetia, our international partner. Can we have a big round of applause for all our partners? Dr. Manjari Prabhu, could you please share your thoughts on PILF with us?
His Excellency Lorenzo Angeloni, esteemed Advisory Board Member Shobha Day, the backbone support of PILF, Bharat Agarwal, Managing Director, Vishwakarma Publications, and Rahul Karad, Executive President, MIT World Peace University, and friends. Every year, I stand here during an inauguration and I feel I should say something different, something wonderful, something meaningful. And really, all I feel is immense gratitude for this day. It's a culmination of months of hard work, commitment, passion, and teamwork, and I really feel blessed. PILF is now in its sixth year, and what an exciting journey it has been. I think you've just seen the film. We had so many speakers that we just can't have all of them in the film, but really we have more than 600 speakers, really great speakers. Putting a Lit Fest together is serious business, and that we have sustained this effort to the sixth year is a credit to our fantastic team, our supporters and partners, media, and a venue like Yashoda. And firstly, I would like to thank all of them from the bottom of my heart, especially Shri Rahul Karad and Shri Bharat Agarwal. We are privileged here to have His Excellency Lorenzo Angeloni, and as we celebrate 70 years of Indo-Italian friendship, I hope that it is the beginning of 70 years of PILF Italian friendship too. Thank you very much, sir, for your enthusiastic participation in the festival. There are many sorts of people who come into your life for many reasons. Some come to help you to achieve your dream. Having Shobha Day here today brings back a lot of memories, and it's a very special moment for me. In 2013, when we were really raw, it was Shobha who pooled in her contacts and helped PILF go live. I'll never forget that. Shobha, I hope that today you see the results of that trust in us. Today, PILF is rated one of the top literary festivals of India, and we're really grateful to Pune City and its fantastic response to the festival, as well as all the publishers and eminent speakers who grace the event. Although I say this, I do know that the real essence of the need for books and art is still to be completely understood in our society. I have two examples to support this. We have some college students who love to be a part of the organizing team. Not MIT, and I'm not talking about those, but generally people like to come in and help us. But they are forbidden by their parents and family members to waste their time in a literary fest. And they feel they're better off studying. So I feel that some parents today still need to be told the advantages of the experience gained at a LitFest, because it shows a complete lack of awareness. And I hope that PILF will gradually kind of make up for that. The other side is, of course, sponsorship. Any LitFest needs funds, and you would think that after 5 years of doing our best to prove ourselves, it would now be easy for us to attract more funders. But the hard truth is that even today, we struggle to get sponsors. People tell us outright on our face that they would rather give their money to hospitals than frivolous events like ours. Donating to hospitals is a great cause, very noble, of course. But has anyone ever considered the possibility that if you donate to preventive measures like literature and the arts, you may find less need to donate to curative measures? Literature and the arts are a prerequisite to love, peace, and a tolerant, understanding, and accepting society. I very firmly believe in that, and Pune International Literary Festival is a product of this belief. I just want more and more people to believe in this belief, just the way Rahul Karan and Bharat Agarwal have done. Our social theme this year is family, and some sessions are dedicated to this theme. Families don't desert you, no matter how absurd your dream or how impossible and crazy your love. PILF is a sterling example of it. And I want to thank my family and friends that they've been in my life every step of my, you know, of this dream. Finally, welcome to the 6th edition of Pune International Literary Festival. It is here because each one of you, present here, and because of the wonderful media support and all those invisible but active behind the scene well-wishers too. Thank you.
Thank you, Dr. Manjari. A few thoughts from our partners are also in order. Mr. Bharat Agarwal, please share your experience of being with PILF.
His Excellency, the Ambassador of Italy, Lorenzo Angeliano, Shobha De, Rahulji Tharad, Manjari Prabhu, my dear audience, good morning, good afternoon to all of you. It's, I think, so the fourth or the fifth time that there is a PILF opening event and I am supposed to be here. It's a good partnership that we have been sharing with PILF for so long, and we are delighted to know that the festival has sustained in terms of attracting the audience and, in fact, enriching the content of the festival, thereby attracting more audience towards the festival. The list of speakers this year goes to 170 numbers, 100 sessions. So much of content, so much of good, high-quality content in 3 days. I am sure the audience, the city of Pune, will be privileged to hear all the speakers, all the authors during the festival. Vishwadharma Publications is a venture of Vishwadharma Institute's group, which owns the Vishwadharma Institute of Technology, the VIT College, as well as Vishwadharma University. The publications has been doing work in the area of publishing Marathi as well as English books. We do sponsor a competition every year in PILF wherein we invite authors, or I would say first-time authors, to submit their manuscript to us. We judge the manuscripts and we commit to the authors that the winners will be published by next year. I am sure this year, Manjari, in the schedule there is somewhere publishing of the books of the last year winners. And I also know that there would be announcement of the competition winners of this year. So good luck to everyone who has come to be part of this festival. I am myself very eager to listen to all the authors and speakers as much as possible for me. Thank you so much.
Thank you, Mr. Bharat. We would now invite Mr. Rahul Karad to say a few words, please.
Janani Janmabhumisha Swargadapi Gariyasi. Good afternoon, everybody. I'm very glad today that the 6th edition of Pune International Literary Festival, we are just inaugurating here. And every year I participate. I think once only I missed it because of some other commitment. But I remember long back, 6 years before, when Mr. Prabhu, when he came to my institution for the first time, and there is some idea which is coming up, and my wife, she want to build up one such platform. And me as an institution builder, my father, Dr. Karad, who is the founder of this prestigious group of institutions called MIT Group of Institutions, Pune, which is among those 25 education groups in the country who created a private education culture in this nation. And I'm very happy that this very institution has propagated this idea of MIT World Peace University, Honorable Ambassador. This is one of the unique institutions, Shobhaji, that for the first time in the global academic history, there is an institution which is a professional institution which says a World Peace University, where we create engineers, doctors, professionals, and pharmacists, and all kinds of degree programs. But the base is literature, base is the philosophy, base is the foundation is how do we unify the science and spirituality. And this particular sixth edition, the very theme, which is based on the family values, and this very country has always propagated the Vasudeva Kutumbakam, the world as a whole family. So I compliment Manjiri ji, whose hard work and commitment has established this very platform, not just for city of Pune, Maharashtra, but for the whole country and all over the world. And here at our institution, MIT World Peace University, my students are listening. There are some volunteers here and some other audience. I must say that we have imbibed very beautifully that in the engineering program, how do we communicate to them about literature, philosophy, so that they become the complete person. At one side, BA literature and such programs are dying out in our country. Everybody wants to become engineer or a doctor. And this is not a good sign for the country like India or for that matter, any nation. And here is an institution, MIT World Peace University, which says that how do we unify science and spirituality so that our engineers, our doctors, our professionals, they become a complete person. And my belief is unless and until you go through the literature, the cinema, the films and arts and music, you can't be a complete person. So with that spirit, the MIT World Peace University is working, and I'm very happy that from day one, Pune International Literary Festival is jointly organized in association with my institution, and Manjiri Prabhu, of course, she heads it, she owns it, she leaves it, and you know, and I compliment, and I always, whoever such people in this field, I meet them, and I say, ki, India needs a scaling. India population is so much, and with that spirit, this small audience, when I see, I mean to say, it's a very large audience here, but I always believe that in this country, 3.5 crore students are taking higher education. We have some 15 lakh teachers, 1.5 million teachers who are imparting higher education in this country. So I have one suggestion, Manjiri ji, you have your own thoughts. I think initially it happened that first two editions we conducted at MIT World Peace University. And we collectively with our discussion, we said that no, this has to be a neutral platform and it must go outside. And that's how we chosen this very particular venue. But with the demographic dividend and the young India, if we see, and how do we really attract, you just now explained in your speech that how do we really attract the youngsters into this literature and philosophy and this, they are shying away, and how do we do? So with that spirit, Madam Manjiri, I want to communicate to you that this city of Pune has a Pune of city, and Bangalore used to be the city of education. And with that spirit, if you can, because there is a lot of challenge for the institution building and the and with the foresight, and if we really have to a permanent platform creation vision, so with that spirit, if we can rotate to all the institutions every year, is come forward, MIT come forward, so likewise various institutions can host this, and it can, and why I am saying this, not that because it is not working here, it is beautifully working here, but the purpose is all the people sitting here and all that, the how do we engage the youth in this country so that the student community, they also feel liking that literature, ye literature tha, ye sab ye budde bade log, 5-50 ke baad iske bare mein, to and because of the TV and YouTube and this, people are not reading much. And here at my institution for engineering program, nobody gives a biography studies. 4 biographies for engineering program we have imbibed. There are some 15 must watch movies we have imbibed for the 4-year mechanical, civil, petroleum, polymer, chemical engineering student. So that at the day as they pass out, they become a complete person. The music appreciation, the film appreciation, and about the family values, I think this is the very core of this country, and I think India has always propagated this thought. And I'm very happy that this year you chose this theme, Manjiri ji. You are like a family, and I must compliment all the family members, all the sisters in particular, and the mother of Manjiri ji, who is sitting very much, and whom I look at like a guru. She's a great astrologer of this country. And I compliment all the family members, all the partners who supported this cause. And Mr. Chowgule, I compliment you that you became instrumental initially. You know, and I always believe that how people meet in life, why you and me, you know, there are thousands of people in the society. Why certainly just now I was just sharing with Honorable Ambassador and I said about the Aosta. There is one beautiful place, Paradiso, in Italy. So I went there. So in a minute we connected with each other. Why only certain people meet in life, Agarwalji? So that, and I think this is one very powerful platform to develop the minds of the society, to develop the youngsters of India and the world. So with that spirit, I get emotional, you know, when I see, and whoever in individual capacity they work, I always say to them that please establish the organization, institution. And I must tell that in one of the Rajbagh, I'm taking a little longer, but I must say that we have this Raj Kapoor family donated a beautiful land called Rajbagh. And there we have created a world biggest dome for the humanity and the world peace. Of this organization, my father, he is a visionary. Last 15 years, the work was going on. At the age of 65, Honorable Ambassador, he started working. Today, he is almost 80. And imagine the vision and the commitment. And here is a world biggest dome where he has laid down the, for every family, there is some foundation. We carry pride for our father, mother. India, we carry pride for Buddha, Gandhi. Italy, they carry the pride for their own heroes. In the same way, who are the world heroes and who laid the foundation for this world? So there are some 54 statues which are laid down. Who laid the foundation for we humanity? We as a whole world and the Vasudeva Kutumbakam. And Plato, Kant, Hegel, Spinoza, Faraday, Einstein, Santa Ganeshwar, Sant Tukaram, Swami Vivekananda. So all the world such thought leaders, statues we have laid down there, 54 statues. And like the way all the rivers, how finally they meet the sea and ocean is one. So with that spirit, we as a whole world is one society. And this is a beautiful structure. So maybe on 2nd of October, Vice President of India is inaugurating. Hopefully on 24th of October, President of India is also coming to inaugurate this. I mean to say deliver the first address. And many other leaders and the spiritual thinkers, Nobel laureates, scholars, philosophy people, they are coming. Shobhaji, I wish that someday you come there. You are a lady, an iconic lady. All youngsters and the previous generation people, they all love you. And there is such a wonderful connect. So I think I want you to really think that, I always believe, you know, because the celebrity status, it will not come like that. And she has worked hard for that. But my feeling is, how do we really pass on the benefit? 3.5 crore students of this country, I keep thinking about them. How do we really pass on? Higher education, school education, of course, so many students are taking education. So please think, Manjiriji, about this idea. Thank you so much once again. All of them I compliment and love you. Thank you. Jai Hind, Jai Bharat.
Thank you so much, Mr. Rahul. We now request Ms. Shobha De to speak a few words to us.
Namaskar. मला मराठीत बोलायचं फार इच्छा आहे. माझं मराठी फार चांगलं नाही आहे, पण तरी पुण्यात येऊन इंग्लिशमध्ये बोलायला जरा विचित्र वाटतं, बट आय हॅव टू स्विच. आय एम सो डिलायटेड टू बी हिअर. 6 years आफ्टर वी स्टार्टेड PILF, इट वॉज रिअली मंजरीज पॅशन अँड कमिटमेंट अँड इमेन्स हार्ड वर्क अँड सेन्स ऑफ really a vision for what she wanted with this literary festivals. I don't know how many of you are aware that there are over 150 literary festivals across India today. So it is a very competitive field, and that Pune has managed to establish itself as well as it has says a lot about Manjri, her team, the volunteers, everybody here in this room, everybody who supported it, the sponsors. It is to her dynamism and to her credit that PILF is where it is today. I have seen it grow, and it gives me immense pride to see what it has grown into. Because it's one thing for a festival to just grow, that's not that difficult, and to become one more jamboree in a crowded field. But to keep its focus very much on books, writers, ideas, imagination, that needs a certain kind of, I would say, a deep understanding and a deep investment in the world of ideas. When I was coming to Pune this morning I brought a book with me which I haven't yet finished. It's called The World is Just a Book Away, and it's put together by a professor in California, and it has the most splendid essays written by some of the great minds, from the Dalai Lama to other professors, to filmmakers, to activists, to poets, philosophers, and each one of them was asked to pick one book that made a difference to their lives. And I was extremely honored and very flattered to be included in this wonderful list. And when I had to think and pick just one book, I had to think really hard, because books have always been my best friends. I've grown up in a middle class environment where my father spent and invested wisely in books and didn't give us the latest toy or the latest anything from the market. The limited resources he had were spent on books, so I grew up with books as my allies. It was very, very difficult to pick just one book that I felt was my mantra for life. And then I thought, it's not that difficult at all, because at the end of it, we go back to roots, we go back to the theme of this festival, which is family, and that wonderful word called kutumb, which is very inclusive. It's not just about your immediate family. It's not about your brothers and sisters and father and your cousins and chachas and buas and mamis and so on. It is really a deeply philosophical world that sees all of us as belonging to a family that's global, and that's how it should be. So the book I picked was the Mahabharata, and particularly my ongoing crush, if I may call it that, on Krishna. And what a character. I don't think a better character has ever been written or invented, because he had, with all his great, great wisdom and his cunning and his flirtatious ways, he was as human as anybody sitting in this room. And the more I wanted to get to know Krishna, and I wondered why it had taken me this long to get to know him. And my short essay in that particular book is all about looking for Krishna. And I think we all look for Krishna, or our versions, or our hope for meeting that Krishna, and that Krishna can be a female. And I think he could have been anything or anybody, and his advice to Arjuna is the best advice anybody can ever give anybody, in terms of just the practicality and the strategic thinking just before going to war. And Arjuna's confusion is equally human. So to me, it was the most perfect book that I can keep referring to, especially those words of advice. And I liked also Krishna's arrogance. Arrogance, I find, can be a very attractive quality in anybody if you can back it up with something. And when Krishna says that I am the opulence, they can't, it is not, it's just a flat statement. It's not even a boast. And that's what makes it so wonderful. I am the opulence. I mean, imagine being able to say that. How fabulous. So books, and this is what we're here to celebrate, books, and to get young people to read, which is really a huge, huge challenge. But I think that I have five grandchildren, and I have encouraged my own six children to read, even if it's for 5 minutes a day, anything that interests them, because their attention span, being what it is, anything beyond 5 minutes, and they're really not there. So you may as well be reading to yourself. To get the young engaged, you have to also make reading something that is engaging. And I think it's up to parents and teachers, and they can do it, and it's not all that difficult. So with these words, I would like to wish PILF huge success. The lineup of speakers is spectacular. It's important also that in Pune, which has been for all of India really the center of literary rebellions in the past, may it continue to be that center of rebellion. In this day and age, too many writers are under threat. And it's important that every writer, wherever he and she may be, has the freedom of expression, which is guaranteed to us by our constitution. We should remind ourselves of that, particularly in Pune, where some of the greatest literary voices have emerged that have inspired India, inspired the freedom movement. And let not a single voice be suppressed in our democracy. That is my great wish. I hope all the speakers who participate will remember that we have those freedoms, we should cherish them and fight for them till our last breath. You surrender a freedom and you're a dead society. And I can't ever see India becoming a dead society, ever. We have what it takes to inspire the rest of the world, and we must use that opportunity. Platforms such as this provide that opportunity, and we must take advantage of all these platforms and speak up and speak up and speak up. So here's to a great festival. Here's to the next 3 days of learning and enjoying. And we must take full advantage of the Sula wines that are going to be available to all of us. And with that, thank you very much. I look forward to my own session with Nadi. And great, good luck. Good luck.
Thank you, dear Shobha, for your kind words. His Excellency, Mr. Lorenzo Angeloni, we would like you to share your thoughts with us.
Dear Shobha, dear Manjari, dear speakers, special guests, ladies and gentlemen, namaskar. It's not the first time that I'm here in Pune, on the plateau. By the way, I come from a city in Italy which was built on top of a hill, so there are some similarity. And I like very much Pune. I think that is at the same time a very alive place and still rooted to its culture. But this time is kind of a special occasion because of my first participation to your sixth PILF, and I have to say that the very warm welcoming that I received this morning, and also before when I met Manjari and the husband in Delhi at the embassy when they were presenting the sixth edition, so put me in a very relaxing mood to the point that I had already forgot that I received my show before, and I was going for the second one. It is very interesting that I'm the third speaker that refers, it was here in my notes, that refers to the expression Vasudeva Kutumbakam. I'm the third one. And it's very amazing for me because I was always struck by this expression since the very first days after my arrival in India, because it matches with the way I see at diplomacy, first of all, at life also. And if you just think over the fact that diplomacy at the end is sort of construction of bridges. So we, the diplomats, we try to bring people together. This is what we are doing. And this expression was always a sort of polar star in my staying here in India. I didn't know this expression before arriving in Delhi. And this was something really very, very important for me. And I think that there is a beautiful, short, and powerful expression that tell everything. And I think that it's very important that this PILF edition is devoted to family, because at the same time, the polar star is shining, but on Earth, family is under some risks. And I think we have all to work and to strive and to work together to make this very fundamental institution of a society stronger and working all together for that. So let me just finish these few words thanking in a heartfelt way Manishi for inviting me. But when I say Manishi, I say the sister of Manishi, I say the brother of Manishi, I say the husband of Manishi. I don't know how many other relatives I have to thank you, but I think that you are really doing a great job here. It's unbelievable to make this. I didn't know that 150 literary festivals are held held in India. So it's really unbelievable the work done. And I had in my previous capacity some experience with organizing events. And I can tell you that it's very, very hard to let roll events like this. So once again, thank you very much, and a great success to PLF. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Mr. Lorenzo, for your inspirational words. It's now time for some excitement. Every year, Vishwakarma Publications has a manuscript competition, and they select the manuscript for publishing. Vishwakarma Publications will now launch the book published by them of the winner of the 2017 manuscript competition. I request Mr. Vishal Soni of Vishwakarma Publications to come up on stage and carry on with the proceedings.
Please do the honors.
And now, it's time to announce the winners of the competition for the manuscript selection for publishing for the year 2018. I request Ms. Shobha Day to do the honors.
Well, here are the winners for this year, and their books will be published next year by you. I like this publisher. Piglet's Journey, the author is Bipatram Kanjilal. Dragon's Prophecy, author is Anish Kulkarni, and Hawa Mahal Murderers. You like crime thrillers? Okay. A small suggestion from me for next year, I can be a little presumptuous being a friend of Manjari's and also part of the advisory board, that perhaps from next year we could have a special section for Marathi literature and Marathi poets and have a more better representation of Maharashtrian writers, and that would be even make this festival even. No, we include that as part of the festival to have a parallel festival with and give them equal importance and have their voices heard in Pune and beyond. Thank you very much. Thank you.
Thank you, Shobha. Let us take this excitement ahead into the next 3 days of the festival. Hope you all have a lovely time and experience the thrill of the literary adventure of PILF. Thank you, our guests, and thank you to all of you.